My dear friends, welcome to our tutorial series dedicated to cryptocurrencies. Today, let's talk about cryptography. Cryptography can be defined as the collection of techniques that seek to guarantee secure communications. Cryptography has therefore two major parts: data encryption and digital signature. Digital signature will be the subject of the next video. In this video, we will only talk about data encryption. Data encryption is the process of scrambling an intelligible input data, also called plain text, into an unintelligible mass of data, also called ciphertext. Let's take for a moment the example of a Rubik's Cube. In its initial state or solved state, the Rubik's Cube has a very simple appearance. Each face has defined colors: white, red, blue, orange, green, and yellow. However, when the cube is crumbled, it becomes unintelligible, and there are 43 quintillion possibilities to make the cube return to its initial state. Fortunately, if you know the process by which this particular Rubik's Cube was crumbled, you can apply this process in reverse to obtain the initial state. In cryptography, the scrambling is called encryption, while the unscrambling is called decryption. The process used in both scrambling and unscrambling is called the cipher. Historically, the Caesar cipher is one of the simplest and first cipher ever invented by humanity. It consists of two concentric disks, one inside the other. Both disks have all the letters of the alphabet engraved on the upper side. The inner disk has its alphabet shifted by 3 letters. The encryption process is done by reading the letter on the first disk and writing its corresponding letter on the inner disk. The Caesar cipher, despite its ingenuity, can easily be broken simply by analyzing the frequency of occurrences of certain letters. In order to solve the limitations of the Caesar cipher, an improved design was created, the Alberti cipher. The Alberti cipher has the same layout as the Caesar cipher, except that the inner layer is movable. Encryption is done by putting the inner wheel into an agreed upon initial position, then associating the characters from the outer disk to their correspondences on the inner disk. The initial position of the cipher is done by putting an arbitrary letter, also called index letter, under a given upper letter on the outer disk. The choice of the index letter is kept secret between the sender and the receiver of the message. Therefore, the Alberti cipher is the first cipher to have introduced the concept of key. In this case, the key is the single character index letter. Most recently in history, multi-character ciphers were developed, of which the most popular is the Enigma cipher or Enigma machine. The most important part of the Enigma machine was the rotor mechanism, which was made of a rightmost input wheel, 3 to 8 permutation wheels, and a last wheel called the reflection wheel. Contrary to its predecessors, the Caesar and Alberti ciphers, the Enigma machine was mostly electric. Messages were encrypted by passing an electric signal through the input wheel. Then the signal will go through each permutation wheel, and finally the encrypted letter was displayed using lamps next to the keyboard, each lamp for each letter of the alphabet. After each encrypted letter, the permutation rotors will rotate one step. To be able to decrypt a message, in addition to having the same model of the Enigma machine, the receiver of the message had to know the initial states of the rotor mechanism used by the sender. These initial states, just like with the Alberti cipher, can be considered a secret key, in this case a multi-character key shared between the sender and the receiver. In cryptography, when the key is kept secret between the sender and the receiver, we talk about private key cryptography. However, secrets are difficult to keep, especially when more than one person is involved. For this reason, private key cryptography can easily be broken. In the case of the Enigma machine, the messages were frequently broken and intercepted. For this reason, cryptography moved to public key cryptography. In public key cryptography, the message is encrypted by a key known by everybody and can only be decrypted by using a private key known only by the legitimate receiver of the message. To understand public key cryptography, think about a mailbox. To be able to send a message, i.e. mail, to that particular mailbox, you need its mailbox address. But once you have posted your mail to that address, only the owner of the key to that mailbox can open it and retrieve the mail. In cryptography, the keys aren't made of metal, but of series of characters or bytes. The mailbox is the internet, and the mailbox address is the public key. In modern time, encryption is no more performed by spinning wheels, but through mathematical computations performed by ever faster computers. Therefore, breaking a modern cryptography cipher is mostly about solving a complex mathematical problem. The longer the key length, the more difficult the mathematical problem becomes. Today, a 256-bit, that is 32 characters long key, guarantees the maximum security in most applications. Thank you for your time. If you enjoyed the video, please like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.